We have many questions to ask ourselves during these troubling and uncertain times. What's happening in our world? What's happening in our country? What's happening in our city? What's happening in our lives? What's happening in our families? St. Paul, John Paul II, in his farewell to the address to the people in Detroit in 1987, said this about America. America, your deepest identity and truest character as a nation is revealed in the position you take towards the human person. The ultimate test of your greatness in the way you treat every human being, but especially the weakest and the most defenseless ones. The best tradition of your land presumes respect for those who cannot defend themselves. If you want equal justice for all and true freedom and lasting peace, then America, defend life. All the great causes that are yours today will have meaning only to the extent that you guarantee the right to life and protection for all people, the unborn and born, but especially the human person. Where do we find our hearts? Where do we find our souls? Where do our brothers and sisters today find themselves? Maybe it's in the fearfulness. Maybe it's in our anger. Maybe it's in our hatred, our frustration, our jealousy, our envy. If this is what our hearts and souls are full of, then we are doomed. We have lost our souls. We've lost our hearts. We have lost our country. A wise man once said, if you feed your hearts and souls with evil and anger and hatred and vengeance, your lives will become evil, angry, and hatred. You will only know the evil, angry, and hatred. And again, it becomes a part of life. But if you fill your hearts and souls with peace, hope, and justice, and love, then you will know what peace, hope, and justice, and love are. You will not only know them, but you will experience them. From the scriptures today, we hear in the first reading about Adam and Eve. Their hearts and souls are turned away from God. When they realize their sinfulness, they hide themselves from God. Yet God calls, "Where are you?" Adam answers, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." God calls each and every one of us in a special way out of sinfulness. Sinfulness is like our nakedness. We have no way to hide or cover ourselves from God. God sees into our hearts and souls. He calls us out of the darkness of our evilness into the light of his mercy and peace and love. We must awaken in us an awareness. St. John Paul II said, every human person, no matter how vulnerable or helpless, no matter how young or old, no matter how wealthy or healthy or handicapped or not or sick, no matter how useful or productive for society, is a being of inestimable worth created in the image and likeness of God. Each person is sacred. This is the dignity of America, the reason we exist. The condition for her survival, yes, the ultimate test of her greatness, to respect every human person, especially the weak and the most defenseless ones. Jesus in the gospel today and his moment of defenseless reminds each and every one of us, even in our most difficult moments, our most difficult times of trials and tribulations, even our moments of pain and suffering and anger, he too, as he laid upon the cross, said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to his disciple, "John, behold your mother." Jesus does not leave us alone. He leaves his loved ones not abandoned, but loved, with the care of a mother who is his mother, who is our mother. Today, Jesus will not leave us or abandon us. He sends us the Holy Spirit to heal and guide us, as we celebrated yesterday on the Feast of Pentecost. He will also give us Mary, his mother, who was not afraid to say to God, "Let it be done unto me according to your word." We too must not be afraid to pray. And as we sometimes pray, but as we sometimes too sing, our greatest hymn in God Bless America, we sing these words, "God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies, to the oceans white with foam, God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above." When we sing that song, our hearts are stirred with a greater awareness of who we are, our identity. Yes, we are American. Yes, we love God, and we bless the Lord for the gift he has given us. And yet, when we come to pray, let us stir our hearts too. Let us stir our hearts and minds when we say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen."